It's getting very late and all of you are getting impatient. So I'll keep my speech as brief as possible. First of all, I would like to thank the management of Indian Institute of Hotel Management and specifically Ms. Navunita Kaur, its director, for inviting me to this wonderful event titled Novato Fiesta as a guest of honor. I would like to make a very brief speech for the students, and I am also daunted a bit by the distinguished speakers of eminence who spoke before me and the galaxy of sparkling faces that I see all around. Okay, let me start my speech, that is whatever I have to say to the students. I have practically no experience about the hospitality industry from the inside. However, being a keen traveler and born into a family consisting of wanderlust parents, I have been a constant consumer of the hospitality industry. This experience, of course, gives me some, but very limited experience of coming in close contact with the hospitality industry. I am going to share two of my theories connected to the hospitality industry with the young aspirants who are looking for a successful career in this industry. These two learnings or theories, as I call them, are as follows. I think the theory of stoicism applies to the hospitality industry like no other industry. Being a part of the hospitality industry is almost like being a part of the performing arts industry. Your personal universe and your public universe are deeply split. While you may have a very grim situation in your personal universe, however, you are always required to shine with a smiling face in the public universe. This is not something learned very easily and also cannot be learned in classrooms. This comes with strong and rock-solid experience as you face the contours of the external world. Secondly, the theory of accidental conversation also applies to this industry like nowhere else. I was in 2014 staying at the Taj Mahal Palace Hotel in Mumbai and sipping a cup of black Darjeeling tea in the coffee shop overlooking the gateway of India, enjoying the landscape of the misty Arabian Sea dotted with pigeons, boats and travelers from all across the world. I picked up a conversation with a middle-aged manager from the F&B department of the Taj Mahal Palace Hotel, and as we got comfortable with each other, he narrated me two stories of having met Sean Connery and Salman Rushdie. Of course, in case of Salman Rushdie, it was long before Iran had issued a dictate or fatwa on his head. As I understood from this gentleman, while he had watched one or two James Bond films starring Sean Connery and not any other films of his major body of work and had not read a single Salman Rushdie work, yet these accidental conversations appealed to him because they were rich with intensity and rewarded him with a kind of experience which he was not aware of earlier. And this gentleman kept on repeating to me that these accidental conversations are the real bonuses of their kind of work, because people like Sean Connery and Salman Rushdie will not care to pick up a conversation with a stranger outside an ambience and environment of comfort. In a way, the labor of the theory of stoicism is compensated by the pleasure of the theory of accidental conversation. This, I would say, is the law of conservation of pain-benefit ratio operating in the hospitality industry. All the best to all of you. I can only wish all of you to strive for a very successful future. Nothing comes without sincere hard work. Thank you once again. But before vanishing from the stage, I would like to tell you, remind you once again that yesterday was Teacher's Day, and everything that we study or work through in a management institute is all about education. So we have to deal with teachers. So I got a WhatsApp message yesterday about education, which I would like to share with all of you. Maybe, I mean, WhatsApp is so mysterious that you might have got the message yourself. But I would like to, it's a very small message, I would like to read it out to all of you. Now this is titled Education. A school principal who survived the Nazi camp wrote, "I am a survivor of a concentration camp. My eyes saw what no person should witness. Gas chambers built by learned engineers, children poisoned by educated physicians, infants killed by trained nurses, so I am suspicious of education. My request is to help your students to be human. Your efforts must never produce learned monsters, skilled psychopaths, or educated maniacs. Reading and writing and spelling and history and arithmetic and management are only important if they serve to make our students more human. Thank you. Good night."